السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Good morning everybody. Today inshallah we talk about the important tools of the quality tools. It is Flowchart, and this is presented for the course MDT 445. And the instructor of this presentation, Dr. Mohamed Asiri. My name is Mohamed Hamid Bakhsh, and my friend Abdullah Omar and Suleiman Jamal. The outline of this presentation is definition, explanation, procedure, practical uses, examples, and references. And now I'll continue with my friend Suleiman.
Assalamu alaikum. Flowchart is a type of diagram representing a process using a different symbol containing information. Information about steps or sequence of event. Each of these symbols is linked allows to illustrate the flow direction of the process. Now we will explain the flow chart with Mohamed Hamid.
This shape is indicated for the beginning or end of the program for your diagram. And this is a parallelogram shaped is indicated for either input or output information for your program in Flowchart. And this is a rectangle is represented for the process. And also indicated for process or action. This shape is indicated for direction between the shapes and also direction of the process that follow. This is a diamond shape. This is indicated for the decision. And also indicated for decision point between two or more paths. And after you finish the decision point, the program should continue one or two routes. And this is a double line rectangle. Is indicated for marker steps or more steps. And now continue the procedure with my friend Abdullah.
Now we have how to create the flow chart. First, are there decision path? Yes, to create decision map. After that, the lab of section delay, decision data. After that, open up flow chart, the software. Select the sample, that math of each, organize the sample of based on the work path, use the arrow of indicate workflow, use the color of indicate departments, create the color key. Now we have the list of procedure. First, write you out your core concept. First, we have to write the concept basis on the key. For the successful its read. Second, R shows the base of the concept sample and develop the concept and explanation. Make sure that have the, is the clear point. It will be to help to make it the easier for reading. The second one, the decision between the standard and sampling of format. Means if you have a multiple groups to involve to process outline its flow chart. Second one, the each of step are responsible to completing the task. Third, we have the layout of your flow chart. Means the most of flow chart, most of flow chart means the and the brain of principle use a different shape of represent. The different type of the concept decision. Fourth, we have the separate complex of process. Means the area of the flow chart becoming in the task and the separate sub of the process. When you have a new flow chart, add the box of the reference to the sub process. In the original flow chart, have the read to return when they get the extended of section. Now, with my friend Suleiman.
I will talk about practical uses. First, there is many practical uses in flowchart. First, in complex application, flowchart is being used to create in computer software system design. Also, in practical application, is served as an structure manual in the academy. Also, in industrial. They usually use a flowchart in a guide. They usually use a flowchart as a guide in their work. In government office, a flowchart is being used for their future plan, so it can be made available for the public. In business organization, they use a SIT or flowchart to perform situational analysis and standard approaches to make sales and marketing. Now there is some example with Abdullah.
Now I have the example of Dell troubleshooting of flowchart. When the customer come to the company to have the problem in the computer to fix it, we have two ways. First way, does it turn on? If you say yes, we have to do yes to post the sequence. Is the HD postable? Means the pre-order. After that, we have a does to boot into Windows. After that, we have to save the mode. And after that, does it disappearing to something in the Microsoft helping. After that, we have to does the system store help. After that, we have to do did the hardware pass the destination of test. After that, we have it's the software problem. After that, we have to reinstall Windows. Another way of does it turn on? If you said yes, no, replace the hardware, and after that, we have a problem solved. Thank you for listening to my presentation, and this is the reference.